Bobby Shafran, Eddy Galland, David Kellman, all adopted at birth, and were not aware of each other's existence. So far, interesting, but not remarkable. But then, at age 19, the three boys finally met through a crazy set of circumstances and quickly realized they were identical triplets. It started off as a heartwarming tale that attracted media interest, but then a much bigger, a much darker story emerged, a story told in a new documentary that has earned rave reviews. Three Identical Strangers, which is a hit in theaters. It'll air on CNN in January. Director Tim Wardle joins me now. Hey, Tim, I don't know if the scale is to 4 stars or 5 stars, but I'm giving you the max. I thought it was terrific. I have to say, I laughed and I cried. I mean, you really take us on an emotional roller coaster.
Thank you. Yeah, that's what I'm hoping the film does. You know, it's really encompasses a wide range of emotions. You go to a movie theater and watch it with people. They're laughing at the start. Then they gasp. Then they start crying. And by the end, they're pretty angry. So yeah, I'm pleased that it's being so well received.
I'm not going to give it all away, but Bobby goes off to college. He's driving an old beat up Volvo. If you had asked him, he would have said that he had one sibling. He gets to school, a number of people address him by a different name, and very quickly the pieces fall together. It turns out he has a twin brother, and the twin brother had been on that same campus 1 year prior. Then what?
Well, then the two guys, the two boy brothers find each other, and they celebrate, and they're on the front of a lot of newspapers, particularly in the New York area. And the very next day, they get a call from someone who says, I'm reading about you guys in the paper, and I look just like you. I can see a picture. I look just like you. I think I'm the third. I think we're triplets.
And they were triplets, and this was not by happenstance. This was all by design, that they would grow up in very different environments.
Yeah, and the film kind of explores what happens both after the three of them are united and you know, they become famous in New York and around the world, but also looks at the circumstances behind the separation. As you say, it wasn't just a random event.
And may I also say that despite all of your work and labor in bringing this to a screen, there's a big piece of this we still don't know. Locked away at Yale University is the real story, the full story.
Absolutely. There are a treasure trove of documents relating to the brothers and other twins that were also separated that are kind of locked away in a vault there until 2065 now, we believe.
Is there any prospect that because of your movie, those records will be released sooner than 2065?
Well, the brothers, because of the film and some of the work my producer did, the brothers have got access to some materials relating to them, heavily redacted photocopies. It's very hard to know exactly what they've got. But I'm hopeful that as a result of this film, that the organizations involved and who can grant access will be much more transparent in talking about this study.
Again, not trying to give away too much, but because this was all by virtue of some experiment, for lack of a better description, is there any argument that can be made that the ends justified the means? Did anything come of this? Did we learn anything about three identical twins raised in different socioeconomic backgrounds?
I think that's the question at the heart of the film. I mean, I think various people make an argument that this experiment was justified in the era it occurred in and was started in the 50s and 60s, when there were a lot of rogue kind of scientific, psychology experiments. It was kind of the Wild West of psychology, things like the Milgram obedience experiment and later the Stanford prison experiment, which would not pass any kind of ethical test today. But for me, the point you raise about the knowledge that was gained, I mean, nothing, as far as we're aware, no solid knowledge was gained through all the damage that was done in this experiment. So it remains, in my eyes, pretty unjustifiable.
Let's call it 5. I'm giving you 5 stars. Well done. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. We're at 96 on Rotten Tomatoes. Thank you very much for having me on.
And you deserve it.